Hey guys, so in the recent days we are having a lot of confusion between the helmets and a lot of things. So we have a bunch of guys over here to do an experiment on helmets. There's a lot of confusion prevailing right now for ISI and non-ISI helmets. So today we just decided as a team we'll just figure out to understand which is a safe choice for us. It's an ISI certified helmet. So we got another ISI certified helmet and this is DOT certified now. So you are wondering how we are going to experiment with these helmets now. What are we up to? Yes. Looks as if nothing happened, but it has redefined the shape of the helmet. So the side, the whole thing is gone. This thing is gone. The side thing is gone. And from the top, it could take a decent amount of impact. And there is a thermocol EPS lining. Everything is done. So coming from the DOT certified helmet, this is the condition of the soft shell which is going to absorb the impact during the crash. So I don't see much damages, there are a couple of cracks developed here. So the shape is still intact after having multiple attempts of crashes over this helmet. And EPS looks good on this. So we are coming to this, my ISI buddy over here, and this could take a lot of impact. I'm not telling no to that, but the number of impacts where this EPS is completely out. The amount of shock absorbed is already done. The work of this helmet is over. The rest of the shock and impact is transferred to our head. So this is the white and gray matter of a helmet. And coming to another ISI buddy over here, and I have no plans for the plans. I don't want to really talk about this. And sorry, this is not an EPS liner. This is what I found inside. Basically called as foam. Yeah, there's no EPS liner in that.
Choose wisely which is going to keep your head safe. I thank the Bangalore traffic police being concerned about our safety and bringing in the ISI rule, and at the same time I'm requesting them to just allow us to choose something better than ISI also.